City from Switzerland with a knife collection update at the end of 2018 or the beginning of 2019, depending on when I'm going to post this video. My collection has evolved quite a bit over the time that I recorded my last update, and that's why I thought it was a good time to give you a glimpse into how my collection looks now. I will not going to show you all the knives that are currently listed to be sold, except a couple of the very special ones that you don't see that often on YouTube. These are going to be included, but I will say which ones of the knives that I show you now are actually up for sale at the moment. I will try to do it in a chronological fashion, so I will show you the older knives first and then the newer knives last, but I'm certainly going to get mixed up there a little bit. But let's start out here. So this is going to be a little bit a longer video. I probably have around 50 folding knives that I'm going to show you now, so it's going to be a little bit of a feature length knife video here. So let's start out with a couple of the older knives that I have in my collection, and I still have the one that started it all, and that is the Kershaw Chill. Heavily used, hand polished the blade a little bit, you can see some reflection there. It was actually bead blasted at the start of it. G10 handle scales, liner lock, ACR 13 MOV, running on some nylon bushings, I think. Action is actually quite nice. It was modeled after a design by RJ Martin. I think it's very close to his Q36 model, just in a very small version and with much, much less quality involved there, as well as lesser materials. But actually, I still think it's quite a nice knife, especially for the price that they are going at nowadays and were going at the time. So this was actually my first knife that I actually bought for myself, and that got everything started. So let's put that to the side here in the top left corner. Then soon after that, I got involved in some more knives. Most of them have been sold over time, but the knife that I picked up recently after that was from a new company for me, and that was Real Steel, and this is the H6S1. Pretty good beater knife, very good value for what you're getting. You're getting G10 stainless steel frame lock with a secondary lock, 14C28N steel, which is a very good budget steel from Sandvik, nice corrosion resistance and edge retention, and a very nice fine edge, great ergonomics for my hand size, and one of the best budget blades out there. I think this beats the Ontario Red one by quite a margin, and still one of my preferred beater knives. Here, the Real Steel H6S1 is also one of my most watched knife reviews, actually, and just an amazing knife, and certainly one you should check out if you're looking for a great budget knife with some good steel and great overall build quality, the H6S1 by Real Steel. Then next up, we have a knife from CRKT. It's also pretty long in my collection, and this is this one here, CRKT Ripple 2, in this gorgeous bronze handle scale, amazing knife by Canonian and CRKT. This was a knife purchase that was heavily influenced by Not Fancy, who made a video at SHOT Show where they showed off this particular knife. Same goes for the Chill here. Watched the Not Fancy video and had to have it. And this is just a gorgeous piece. Still one of the best knives that CRKT has ever made, in my opinion. Acuto 440 sealed, rounded spine, great IKBS action, gorgeous bronze coating here on the stainless steel frame, nice and thin gentleman's folder, just the clip is a little bit off, great ergonomics for being this thin, and just a absolutely gorgeous piece here from CRKT, and these can actually be had for quite a bargain nowadays, so I'd certainly recommend to check out the Ripple 2 and get one while you can. Great size, gorgeous knife, and very well made by CRKT. Very, very good action as well. The CRKT Ripple in this gorgeous bronze handle scale color. Then we have a knife that has been showing up quite a bit in my knife reviews, just because it's such a great knife and features my favorite handle material, and that is the Burker Plus Bullpup. In my collection for quite a while as well. VG10 steel, titanium bolsters, micarta handle scales, liner lock, phosphor bronze washers, gorgeous Charles Marlowe design, very nice angled and textured thumb studs, just an absolutely gorgeous knife, a little bit heavy, but size-wise perfect for my hands, very good for doing some harder work, nice hollow grind, just a gorgeous overall piece, and at around $100, a great value here from Boeker Plus, and certainly one I would recommend you to check out. Also gorgeous blade shape as well here on the Boeker Plus Bullpup. Then let's take a look at what else is in my collection for a longer time. We have this one here, which is also a Boeker Plus knife. This is a Brad Zinker design. This is the FR with a Coco Bolo handle scales, nice deep carry clip with some countersunk screws, titanium liners, great bearing action, very nice satin finish on this knife, super thin grind, great slicer, VG10, and a great lower budget gentleman's folder. There are different versions with carbon fiber and G10 onlays. A little bit crammed on the handle here, even for my hands, but certainly a gorgeous piece, also with a rounded spine. Just one of the best offerings of Boeker are these two knives here, in my opinion, and that's also why they have been sticking around in my collection for that long. Then next we have another Boeker knife. This one is from their Solingen factory, so made in Germany. This is the Solo 2 by Boeker, featuring N690 steel aluminum handles with this golf ball style texture, liner lock, nice satin finished clip, designed by Jens Anso, number 439. Nice two-tone finish on the blade here. Great action on phosphor bronze washers. A little bit hard to disengage that liner lock, but also fits my hand perfectly. Love to carry this knife. Also nice and thin in the pocket. Three standoffs in the back. And just a gorgeous, very well made Boeker Solingen model here, the Solo 2. Then some other older knives are here, the Lion Steel SR2 in the aluminum version. This is my only integral knife. You can see here you have duraluminum handles in a green anodizing. We have Sleipner steel black coated blade, because this is a tool steel, stainless steel insert, rotor block, black clip, nice deep carry. Great in hand, a little bit thick behind the edge there, but just a gorgeous design piece, and has not been carried that much, but just something that I like to have in the collection for a representation of integral handled knives. And I certainly like the size of the SR2, and the ergonomics are very nice as well. Gorgeous knife, one of the most expensive knives that I had at the time when I got the SR2 here. We have graduated from that quite rapidly after that, as you will see during the video right here. Then we have a Benchmade, one of my favorite Benchmade overall, and this is this one here. This is the 707 Sequel with the G10 inlays. This nice chalky finishing on the aluminum. I swapped out the clip to a deep carry Benchmade clip. We have 154cm McHenry & Williams design. Great overall size, nice and compact. Great EDC blade, nice access lock action here. Just a gorgeous smaller EDC blade from Benchmade, and probably one of their best offerings of all time, in my opinion. Sadly, they discontinued this knife a year ago or so, and they had a gorgeous version with blue aluminum handle scales. If I can get my hands on one of those, I would pick that up, but now I'm content with the 707 Sequel that I have here in my collection. I got this one actually from the secondary market. Other than that, most of the knives you see here, if I didn't get it from the secondary market, I got it from whitemountainknives.com, which is a great store, and you can also buy some knives from them with my discount code 7READY to get a 10% discount. Then I have a very interesting older knife in my collection, which is this one here. This is the Boeker Keycom, Boeker Plus Keycom, with some gorgeous aftermarket lightning strike carbon fiber scales. There are some voids in the scale there, but it's also super crazy to put such expensive scale on such an inexpensive knife. We have AUS-8 steel. It actually is quite sharp, as long as a pocket clip, as you can see here, so a great fifth pocket knife or backup knife, but I mostly keep it around for the gorgeous scales that it sports. It's a two-finger, maybe two-and-a-half-finger knife, For cutting off straps of some clothing or so, or for opening a letter, it can work, but certainly not something that it would carry as a primary folder. But it actually has some quite nice action, as you can see, so pretty interesting knife. I will leave that one open because of the size. Now let's continue slightly more recent acquisitions here in the collection, and here we have a Gerber Shark Belly, which was released last year. We have a very nice overall design, lightweight wire clip, made in the US, 428C blade steel, back lock with a half stop, and just a gorgeous lightweight carry for the days when you want to carry something lightweight and something a little bit less expensive. Very, very nice knife here from Gerber. And you will see most of these knives have been reviewed on my channel, and you can check their individual reviews out if you want to get some more in-depth information about them. But this is the Gerber Shark Belly, one of the first Gerber knives that I actually got, and one that actually quite surprised me. Pretty good knife here from Gerber, made in the US. Then here we have a knife from Southern Grind. This is the Southern Grind Spider Monkey. Gorgeous knife, S35 VN steel. We have a gorgeously milled carbon fiber handle scales made by Southern Grind. So all of the profits of this knife go to charity foundation that Zach Brown of the Zach Brown Band has founded. He also is the owner and founder of Southern Grind. Gorgeous knife. I call it the Sebenza killer because it certainly has all the attributes it needs to be that. Gorgeous knife, super nice action, and certainly one of the favorite EDC higher end blades in my collection. Just gorgeous carbon fiber, and we have proprietary hardware, but we have a Torx pivot screw. So pretty nice knife and a gorgeous addition to the collection. Also quite a while now in the collection, and certainly one that will stay. Then we have a knife from Kaiser. This is the Guru, also in the collection now for quite a good time there. Titanium handles, S35 VN bearings. This is the thumb stud version. There were also a flipper version available, and there were also versions available without the holes in the blade, holes in the handle there. Great ergonomics, a little bit thick on the blade stock, but overall a great EDC piece and my favorite Kaiser up to this date, the Kaiser Guru, designed by Matt Degnan. Then we have a knife that I got from a very new company at the time, and that is the first Wii knife that ever was released, the 601, in a gorgeous color combination that you don't see that often, with the stonewashed titanium handles, gold and blue hardware. Of course, this sports still their star screws because it was their first offering. Amazing ergonomics, gorgeous satin finish on the blade, amazing grind, super nice action. And when I had this in hand, I knew we would go all the way. And as we know now, they have pretty much dominated the market with a bunch of new releases and collaborations, and they certainly are one of the best manufacturers out there for high-end folding knives as well as budget folding knives, because they have branched out into that realm as well. Put that here. And then we have my favorite knife of last year, which is this one here. This is the Fox Knife Stir. Gorgeous carbon fiber handle, Elmex steel blade, titanium backspacer and clip, amazing ergonomics, Jesper Voxnes design, just an overall amazing knife and a deserving winner of last year for best knife of 2017, and still one of my favorite EDC blades up to date. Put that here. Then I got my first really high-end Grail knife of years ago, and this was a gift by my girlfriend, the small Sebenza 21 in Singo with micarta inlays. Gorgeous knife. And when I got this, I really was into Chris Reeve knives. I saw the value in them, saw the quality that was involved, and then I ordered a couple more Chris Reeve knives over the course of that year. Still an amazing knife, love to carry the Sebenza. Just an awesome, awesome overall knife. And this will certainly never leave my collection just because it was a gift by my girlfriend, and it's just an amazing, amazing folder overall. So now we will bring in the other Chris Reeve knives that I have added to the collection over the course of that year. And that was first the Chris Reeve Umnumzahn. As you can see here, gorgeous knife, amazing action, and just super good ergonomic for my hand size. My finger fits right here in front of this little lock bar extension, and it works absolutely perfectly. A little bit large for me, but I needed to have an Umnumzahn in the collection here. Idaho made, love the finishing of the handle that Chris Reeve does, and the action here on their washer system is very, very nicely done. Gorgeous knife, the Chris Reeve Umnumzahn. And then I also had to have a Mnundi when I saw that they have released their gorgeous spalted beechwood handle scales that year. Of course, steel on all of these is S35VN, and this is probably the gorgeous, most gorgeous gentleman's folder out there. Just very nice in my hands, fits all four fingers. Gorgeous blade shape, very, very smooth action, very nice milled clip, and just some gorgeous wood. The Chris Reeve Mnundi. Then a little bit less high end or less high budget is this one here. This is the CRKT Pilar, which was one of the best releases from 2017, I believe, in the budget knife world. Everybody likes the CRKT Pilar. Gorgeous knife. There are a bunch of new versions of this knife available with Sandvik steel, with S35VN, with carbon fiber handle scales. But the original one came with stainless steel handle scales, stainless steel frame lock, and HCR13MOV. I, over the course of this year, added this carbidized micarta handle scale, and now it is just the way I like it. I would love to have a Sandvik upgraded steel version as well, but I'm pretty content with the package I got here. And this is also one that will stay in the collection because it's such an absolutely great Jesper Voxnes design. You also can see that my collection spans a wide variety of price points. I'm not one that only wants to have high-end materials, but I certainly can appreciate that, and I always try to cover a broad variety of knives on my channel so everybody can pick and choose what is best for him. Then I also got this knife here that I still haven't reviewed just because I don't have the time, and it's this one here. This is a Grayman Duo that I got off the secondary market in this modded version with all matte finished titanium and blade. Great knife. I think Grayman knives need to get some more attention. Here we have CPM 20CV as a blade steel, super, super sharp with this mirror polished edge. Great tank of a knife. I think this beats any Strider or Hinderer in the toughness department. We also have a bushing pivot like a Sebenza. So super, super nice knife, great steel, very good ergonomic, and certainly an absolute tank of a knife here, the Grayman Duo, and also one that will stay in the collection. Then some other knives that I got last year was the Spyderco Spidey Chef. Amazing knife, probably one of the best Spydercos ever released, with their amazing LC200N steel, super, super thin slicer, great finish on the titanium, amazing wire pocket clip. Mine still has the lock stick there. It kind of doesn't want to go away, even with use and flicking it over the course of a year. But it doesn't bother me that much, it's just a very slight amount of lock stick there. But overall, an amazing knife here from Spyderco, great ergonomics, and A little bit large for me to carry, but it folds down to a very nice small and slim package. You don't have your spyderco hump that you get on most knives, so pretty well done here, and one of the best spydercos in my collection. And I now have actually a Techno 2 in the mail, and those two will make a great pair for sure. Then I also got this one here after I got the CRKT version of the bones here, the CRKT crossbones. I had to have a mid-tech version by Jeff Park, and this came up in the secondary market and I had to get it. We have titanium scales, I believe 150 CPM 154 on the blade steel. Super, super nice action. And just a gorgeous overall piece here with the anodizing that has been done and the polishing. The Bones Mid-Tech by Jeff Park. A gorgeous piece. Also not something that I carry on a regular basis. It's more of a little showpiece to have in the collection. I have done an unboxing of this. It also came to be a very nice packaging, and it's just a gorgeous Asian-inspired design that I really, really liked. Also with the skeletonized flipper tab there, and just a great feat of engineering. And a knife that I had to have in a higher end version after I had the Crossbones, which was an amazing knife by CRKT as well. Then I got a couple of Chebukov knives Toucan in the last year. First I got the made to my specification one, which is this one here, M390 Chebukov Toucan, micarta inlays, bronze anodized, titanium and hardware, no inlay under the clip for easier use. Here we have the date of production, which is Q2 of 2017. Bearing action, just super, super nice. Very nice and thin cutting edge on the M390. Great jimping, amazing ergonomics, and just top-notch quality all around. Probably one of my favorite knives overall, the Chebukov Toucan. And over the course of that year, I got the opportunity to pick up this one here, which is a full dress black and white Toucan with a Timascus clip, backspacer and thumb stud, as well as a Sledenok stainless Damascus blade. Milled on the inside, super nice action, and just an absolutely gorgeous showpiece, but I'm not really going to carry this. Just because of the value it has and all the embellishments that it has. And I already got this Toucan right here. You can also see you have a Timascus thumb stud there. And that's why this knife is actually for sale at the moment. So if you're interested in this full dress black and white Toucan, there are only 3 of these knives available in the world. So they only made 3 in this exact configuration. Hit me up if you're interested. I'm willing to let this one go at the right price, just because I don't need 2 and it's just too pretty for me to carry and use. This also comes in a handmade Chebukov leather carrying sheath. Right at the end of last year, I got another Chebukov knife, and this is the small Strich that I got here with the laminated T2. Bronze anodized scale and hardware, blue colored bone inlay, gold anodized steel lock bar, nice clip, and super nice washer action. You can also use it as a front flipper if you like. Works actually quite nice. Very nice size, slim carry, gorgeous clad steel with the laminated D2 steel. You can here see when this was made, also Q2 of 2017. Perfect centering, just an absolutely gorgeous gentleman's piece. Truly amazing craftsmanship here by Alexander Chebukov. And when I got this one, I also got the only fixed blade that I'm going to show you today, and that's this one here, which is a Shogun, very, very small leather opening style tanto with Sledenok Damascus, some hammered bolsters and gorgeous hardwood scales with a lanyard hole in the back. Just an absolutely gorgeous piece that I had to have, even though it's not really practical or anything, but just a gorgeous Japanese inspired Russian piece with some very nice Damascus. Now we'll clean up the top layer here, or the top line, to give a little bit more space for all the knives that are going to come. Now let's go to the even more recent acquisitions, and I got at the beginning of this year, I believe, this knife right here, which was something that I was after for a couple of months then, and this is the Prometheus Design Works Badger, which I also got off the secondary market. A pretty interesting design here by Prometheus Design Works. Reminds you a little bit of Triple Alt Design, I believe. Pretty nice overall knife, smaller knife, pretty thick, but we have a mirror polished edge that slices like crazy. S35VN, very interesting construction. You have a groove cut out of the backspacer so the handle, so the blade can sink into the handle a little bit easier. Great milled clip right there. And a semi-integral construction, so the backspacer is part of the show scale right here. And just a very nice feature is also that you have here some glow-in-the-dark inlays on your thumb studs on both sides. Of course, completely made in the US. And also the cutout for the frame lock is actually a milled slot on the inside. So you don't have a regular lock bar cutout anywhere here on this knife. It's just very interestingly made here on the Prometheus Design Works Badger. But at the moment this is also for sale. I have some other expenses and some new acquisitions coming up, so I need to recoup some cash here. So if you're interested in the Prometheus Design Works Badger right here, hit me up with an offer. Let's go to another higher end knife that I acquired during this year, and that is this one here. This is the Jesse Jaros Model 75 with 154cm blade steel, slate blue G10, black liners, blasted titanium liners, G10 backspacer, liner lock, amazing action, super super smooth, great grinds like you are used to seeing from Jesse Jaros, great size for my hands, just the clip is a little bit of a super high carry clip as you can see right here. So I wasn't going to carry this as much as I had anticipated, so the clip bothers me just a little bit too much. Otherwise the knife is absolutely amazing and something that you should certainly check out. Great jimping, pretty beefy blade there. And this one, because of the clip, is also for sale at the moment. The Jesse Jaros Model 75 in slate blue. Also a knife that I got off the secondary market. Then let's go to some more regularly known knives that came to me in this year. For example, here the CRKT Vaas, other great Jesper Voxnes design, features the field strip technology, FRN handles, a little bit subpar steel if you compare it to some other knives that CRKT has released. So I would love to see this one in a sandwich steel, but overall a great beater knife, great slicer, and just overall a pretty nice design by Jesper Voxnes. Another CRKT of this year is this one here, a Richard Rogers design, the Quattro based on his Vector V2 model. Great deep carry clip, very nicely finished G10 handle scales, great budget gentleman's folder, nice ergonomics, good size overall, very nice IKBS action. And a great collaboration as well here from CRKT and Richard Rogers, which is actually one of my favorite knife makers. Then let's move on to a Tangram knife. This is the Tangram Vector, one of my favorite Tangram knives ever, also including the Vanguard and the Kaiser line, because Tangram is a subsidiary of Kaiser Knives. A great budget-friendly button lock that reminds me a little bit of a Rockset in the milling and handle pattern here. Great overall knife, great size, very good execution of a button lock at a lower price point, which is pretty hard to do and you don't see that often. You can also use it like an access lock like this, so great offering here from Tangram with the Vector, and one that will stick in the collection. Then we have a Spyderco. This is the Reinhold Rhino, a compression log folder by Michael Reinhold and Spyderco, CTS XHP, their laminated carbon fiber, great ergonomics for small to medium hands, and a knife that really needs a clip mod. And with this bug out clip, this is one of my favorite smaller EDC carries. Great knife, super thin, slicey, CTS XHP, very nicely executed handle scale, even though it looks a little bit odd from this side because of this protrusion here, but it works super nice in the hand, and a knife that I really, really like here from Spyderco. Pretty nice release of this year. Then we have the Giant Mouse Ace Biblio M390 steel, gorgeous micarta handle scales, very good ergonomic, and nice liner lock with some bearings in the pivot, good action, a little bit stiff detent, but overall also one of my favorites of this year, by Jesper Voxnes and Jens Anzo of Giant Mouse Knives. And the great thing here about the Ace line is that these are not limited production. Then let's move on to also an absolute favorite of mine is the Protec Cambria. Gorgeous button lock flipper, great action. Love this version in this black and white tuxedo styling with the ivory micarta in the button lock as well as the show scale. Great action, 154 cm. Gorgeous knife by Protec and one of their few manual opening knives. And a great benchmark button lock flipper, in my opinion. If you like button lock flippers, get yourself a Cambria. You will not be disappointed. Then we have my only ZT in the collection at the moment, and that is the 0609 20CV blade. Nice and thin overall package. Gorgeous mil titanium scale in a bronze anodizing color. I got an aftermarket clip. There was some controversy regarding the pivot screw, but they have now released the tool for that, so not a big deal for me. And size and ergonomically, this is a great knife for me, a little bit on the larger end, but because of the clip and the overall slim nature of it, I actually like to carry the 0609, and I think this is the best EDC blade that ZT has ever released. That's also why it's going to stick in the collection for a long time. Great RJ Martin design for sure. Then we have the Ramon Chavez Ultramarline Redención Tanto with the green micarta inlays here, made by Riad. Super nice action, probably one of the best Samethod deploying knives regarding the action. Certainly a beastly knife here, also with the Ramon Chavez skull clip there. But one of the pretty interesting new collaborations that came out this year here with the Redención. Gorgeous knife, a little bit on the heavy and bulky side, but from time to time I really like to carry this one here. It's also a great piece to have in the collection. Then staying in the styling, we have the EZE by Alliance Design and Ray Laconico. Great tanto blade, titanium bolster lock, very nice new company here that puts themselves behind the maker. We have the Laconico marking here, but the Alliance Design marking is hidden inside the handle, and just a great new project here, Alliance Designs, and this is certainly a great offering for their first knife and also one of my favorite acquisitions of this year. Now let's move on into the collection and see what else I got this year. We have here, for example, the Line Steel Dom slip joint folder in M390 and natural canvas micarta. A great combination of modern materials and traditional styling. Probably one of the best of these modern slip joints. And a gorgeous blade shape here on the Dom. There are a bunch of different versions of this knife available with a drop point or spear point blade shape, then with a clip point. And all of these knives have been made in collaboration with Collector Knives. And this is actually my own real traditional American style slip joint. Other than that, I have a lot of Victorinox, of course, but nothing along this line of knife styling. Then I also have acquired this year my first Benchmade Bug Out. and I went for this decked out version here with the blacked out blade and bronze hand standoffs in the back and thumb studs, and these Putman micarta scales because I didn't like the original scales that it came with, these Zytel or Grivery handles. Certainly weren't my style, but here with the micarta scales, I absolutely love this knife. Certainly a great design by Benchmade for this year. Then I have the Brian Addo and Riyadh Micro Typhoons. Great, great knife. M390, super nice in the hand. Great size for me, fits all my four fingers. And one of the best knives, if not the best knife of 2018. Absolutely gorgeous knife. It also features the Brian Addo milled D10 knob and gives it this very characteristic action with just one clean break when opening and closing the knife. So absolutely gorgeous piece and a great, great new knife for 2018. Then I also have the Cox Workshop Mini Workman, satin finished, blasted and milled handles, internal milling. Great custom knife from a very little known maker nowadays, and I think his work needs to get a lot more attention just because of the great design, super nice ergonomics, very lightweight, and just very, very well made overall. So if you're interested, check out the video on the Mini Workman. Then I also got my first paramilitary. This is the Para 3, which I got from a very, very generous viewer as a gift. I never really looked into the paramilitary 3, but it actually is a great work knife. This is the standard version in S30V. Great action here on this particular model. I put a Casey Lynch deep carry clip on it, and this is also going to be a knife that will stay in the collection. Just a great overall EDC blade. Love the size of the Para 3 actually. And with a deep carry clip, it's a great knife to carry as well. Then I also got the first modern knife that Case ever has produced in collaboration with Southern Grind. This is a knife that I still have to review. S35VN aluminum handle scales. Interesting placeholder for the clip, made by Southern Grind and designed probably by Case. Gorgeous looking overall lines. A larger blade for me, and certainly an interesting new knife here for this year, the Case CG01. Then I got the Kershaw Copper Natrix, had to get this one. Smaller size, great materials. A design that I always liked, even on the ZT knives. Knockout lock or subframe lock there. Gorgeous knife. Nice patina in qualities with the copper handle there. Maybe we can put it here on the bottom so we can fit a little bit more blades in there. Then we also have this knife right here, which is a prototype of the Hornet released by Tepe Designs that is at the moment running a Kickstarter campaign. So if you want to get this knife funded, please check out the Kickstarter campaign that I will link in the description below. Titanium frame lock folder. I believe the final version will have N690 blade steel bearings, titanium frame lock. Gorgeous, very aggressive design. Can be opened easily with the middle finger flick, thumb opening, or of course the flipper tab. Some nice grinds on the blade right there. You have seen a video on this knife already on my channel if you're following it. Certainly an interesting design here by Tepe Designs, and something that is worth supporting in my opinion. Then I have another Southern Grind knife, actually two Southern Grind knives acquired recently, and this is this one here. This is the Southern Grind Penguin S90V blade steel titanium frame lock. Their patented MTBS multi-track bearing system. This is model 485. We have the pretty interesting penguin tracks here at the top. Smaller milled clip and a great overall action. Also middle finger flickable, great ergonomics. Also a knife that still needs to be reviewed on the channel. Also, we have the Angry Penguin here on the pivot, which is a great thing that Southern Right does on all of their knives. And then I had to pick up this interesting little thing, which is their quill model. We have red backspaces right here. It features a 14C28N Sandvik steels. It's a little stabby little knife here that can be easily concealed and be mistaken for a pen, but you still have a quite capable and fun knife on your person there. Pretty large flipper tab with some jimping, so very easy to deploy every time, and just something interesting that I wanted to feature on the channel. And you will see a review of the quill also later on, probably in early 2019. Pretty interesting and cool little knife here from Southern Grind, the quill. And here you see the animal on the pivot as well on this particular knife. And then just recently, a couple of weeks ago, I got in the Buck 112 in the Pro Slim version with the S35VN and micarta handles. I also got some of the lower end execution with the plastic handles and the 420HC, and I'm going to do a giveaway with those knives as well, because I think this is a great addition to the Buck lineup. Love the ergonomics, great steel, super sharp out of the box, nice clip, a little bit on the broad and large side, but certainly works pretty well in this deep carry. So stay tuned for a review and probably a giveaway on some of these newer Buck releases. And for the end of this video, I have two very, very special knives in my collection. Also two knives that I acquired during this year. Both of them are pretty much grail knives of mine that I was able to acquire during this year, and certainly two stars of my collection. First off, I have the Gareth Bull 3-inch Shamwari, milled titanium version M390, blue accents here on the titanium over travel stop and standoff, as well as the pivot color. Gorgeous hand rubbed satin and polished blade. Just amazing, amazing knife overall. Great ergonomics, amazing clip, and just a really benchmark front flipper, and a knife that I'm very, very happy that I could get my hands on here. You can see the action is out of this world, and I'm very happy to have this one in my collection. Really great knife here, the 3-inch Gareth Bull Shamwari in the milled titanium pattern. And then very recently I got this knife right here, which is an amazing piece. Just super, super blown away by the Rockstead Coup. Just a totally different level of fit and finish and quality that you experience here with the Coup. Amazing mirror polished DLC YXR7 steel. This is model 199, and yeah, just super, super blown away. And I certainly think that these Rockstead knives are pretty much the pinnacle of knife making regarding quality, fit and finish, and just overall craftsmanship. Super, super nice. Of course, I don't have this knife for a long time, so these are more of initial impressions, but this is such a great piece. Just hard to put into words. It really reminds me of a very high-end watch there. Just great, great knife. And these are my highlights of the year regarding acquisitions, and certainly something that wasn't expected by me to get my hands on these very, very impressive knives so early in the collection. But overall, I'm very, very grateful for this year. I think my collection has pretty much evolved quite a bit over this and the last year. Pretty much looks totally different and then my last update that I did a couple of years ago. And I really like to condense my collection to the knives that I think are the best for my uses and for my preferences. And I think I'm on a good track there. I have a bunch of knives for sale, So if you're interested, check out my Instagram feed. I really need to recoup some funds because there were a couple of expenses in this year, of course. And if you're interested, hit me up and we can certainly make a deal there if you want to get some of the knives that I have listed for sale. So thanks again for a great year and for following the channel and supporting the channel. I hope you had a great Christmas and a great new year, and you will see a lot more content during the year 2019 on the channel. And let me know what are your top acquisitions of 2018. I would love to see that in the comments. And thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye. I actually omitted one of my pretty big acquisitions of this year just because it came in so recently and was still packed up in its original box, and I haven't played with it that much, just flipped it a couple of times and checked it out so everything was in order. But I got off the secondary market my brown servo here, so I certainly wanted to add that on here at the end of the video for all the people that stick around. And just a very nice and super smooth knife here from Brown Knives, the servo. And these servos are going to be discontinued in January of 2019, so I wanted to get one before they are no longer produced. So pretty interesting stuff. M390 blade steel, great bearing action, certainly reminds me a little bit of a Grimsmo Norseman or Rosk. Pretty well done overall, and I certainly wanted to include that into the video here. And now for real, thanks for watching, have a nice day, and goodbye.